Affinity to Change is the name that my thought partner, Bob Keegan, and I have given to this concept, which we see everywhere we go, especially where people are looking to make change happen. Change they are really very much wanting to make happen. So basically, it's this in a nutshell. You have a part of you that is very much devoted to making a certain sort of a change, and at the exact same time, there is another part of you that is actively working on a counter goal, which is basically going to keep you in a steady state where you've got a lot of energy trapped in this immune system, one foot on the gas, one foot on the brake, standing still. So the immune system is a fast way of our basically characterizing our deepest humanity that we have. We are complex and we have multiple goals. Mostly we are aware of the conscious goals that we have about changes that we want to make happen, but at the exact same time, we have unconscious goals that very much drive our behaviors. And to the extent we can see our immune system, we are in a, for the first time, powerful position to not be captive of it. Let's start with really an important distinction to make. Technical changes are those changes for which there already exists an expertise, an answer. You might not have it, but somebody out there has it. That is different from adaptive change, where the change actually requires that something new unfolds, a way we can think or feel differently about something. We often need to run experiments in order to see how to actually solve an adaptive challenge. We as a culture are very much oriented towards seeing everything as technical, and we are less likely to see things as adaptive. A big reason for that is because we are happy to see technical solutions. They are much easier. We can check the list off. We can feel like we know what we're doing. Adaptive challenges are much more difficult, and people are often actually quite resistant to even seeing that there is an adaptive nature because they are harder, they are challenging, and they feel more threatening to us. The greatest error that leaders make is mistaking adaptive challenges for technical ones. And the reason why that is such a big mistake is because almost always when we are wanting our organization to engage in new behaviors, it is an adaptive challenge. It leads people to basically feel like they need to do something new and they're not sure they can. So the status quo ends up happening in this very insidious way, which is the nature of an immunity to change. On the one hand, the organization wants to make the change, and on the other hand, they're doing all kinds of things that will try to help the organization move in the right direction, but they're also engaged in doing all kinds of things unwittingly that work against that very change they want to make. Why? Because they have an immunity to change. There is a part of them that is actively devoted to making sure they cover up that they may not be competent in actually having the change unfold, that they may not even have called the right change to happen. And so there's a lot of backpedaling at a very unconscious level. No, nobody would say, okay, really, I don't want to make the change happen. They do. But when we are putting our very kind of sense of our adult competent self, our mature professional self at stake, we come up with all kinds of very clever ways to make sure nobody sees that actually we don't really know how to do this thing, which begins to call into question our own sense of our competency. So fundamentally, from my perspective, the status quo happens because we are ultimately protecting our sense of ourselves as being competent adults.